Hello everyone, welcome aboard. Today again we are back with the next lecture of the ongoing series, and today we are going to discuss about the strategy for Indian polity and how we can maximize the chances of our selection in civil services examinations. So let's get started. So if we look at the trend for the polity, we see that around 13 questions are being asked every year from these subjects. So there are years when we see that there are as many as 22 questions were asked in 2017. And there are years like 2016 when there was only 7 questions asked from this topic. So average being 13, and it makes it one of the very important subjects, including the static portion of the syllabus. So now let's take a look at all the resources that we need. So here in the covering of static portion of the polity, it's going to be very easy. All we need is just one book, Indian Polity by Lakshmikant. Just go for the latest edition, whichever is available in the market, because every year or second, they are launching, coming up with a new edition. And in order to cover the current portion of the Indian polity, there is a website called PRS India. I have given the link www.prsindia.org, which gives you the current or latest development which are happening in Indian polity. These are nothing but we will be needing some information about the current bills or act which has been passed in the ongoing session of the parliament whenever there is an exam. So imagine that if you are going to appear for 2020 prelims exam. Okay, so this exam is supposed to happen on May 31st. That means the preceding session from this prelims is the budget session of 2020, which has happened in the March. So all the bills and act, not all, I would say the important bills and act which were passed in this session. Also, if you were to go one step back, you can check the session of the winter session of 2019. There also you can take a look at important bills and act which has been passed. So this much is enough, and all that information can be easily grasped by PRS India website. Another thing I would like to tell you, that you do not have to prepare bills or act in too much detail. Okay, all you need is a basic information. Okay, what is the aim? What is the mechanism of the act? If there is any new body which is being created to enforce its implementation, that being all. Okay, so now let's move ahead and take a look at some of the important topics which we have to cover. So first and foremost in the Indian polity is the constitution, and this 6 topics are going to be very, very important for you. You can pick up the question paper of any year and just skim through it, all the polity questions, and definitely you are going to find the questions from these area. So evolution of Indian constitution, the multiple acts which were passed during the British administration, then constituent assembly and framing up of constitution, then salient features of Indian constitution, the preamble, fundamental rights, directive principle of state policy, and fundamental duty. This is actually the core area from where lots and lots of questions are usually asked. So again, you don't have to roam around here and there. Just one source, Indian Polity by Lakshmikant, will suffice your preparation for all these topics. Coming to the next topic, union government, consisting of union executive, union legislature, is going to be another very, very important topic. Similarly, state government and local government, which has been added by 73rd and 74th Amendment Act, is another very important area, and you can check the question papers of any year of prelims or let it be mains, you will definitely find some questions from these area. Then Indian judiciary, which is an integrated judiciary with a hierarchy of courts having Supreme Court at its top. So at least we must be having fair idea about the working of Supreme Court of India and the High Court of India. What is the process for the appointment of judges? How their independence is assured? Okay. And what are the different jurisdictions of these two respective courts? Next is the constitutional bodies, different bodies created by the constitution. For example, United Public Service Commission or National Commission for Scheduled Caste, National Commission for Scheduled Tribes. Tell me in the comment section that by which amendment act we have created the National Commission for Backward Classes, the latest constitutional body which has been created. And then the constitutional amendment. Again, guys, we do not have to buy out all the Constitutional Amendment Act. I'll repeat again. We just need to remember the important amendment acts, which are mentioned in the Lakshmikant as you go through from all these chapters, which I have mentioned. Okay. Moving ahead. There are two other things which we have to prepare. So as we discussed, the new bills and acts, for that our source is going to be the PRS India website, the link of which I have mentioned in one of the earlier slides. Another topic which we have to prepare is going to be the non-constitutional bodies like Central Information Commission, CIC or CBI or CVC, NITI Aayog. So all these have been also provided with all the details required to clear the examination in the book which we have discussed itself. So these two topics, one, new bills and act, that has to be covered by PRS India website, and the non-constitutional bodies can be covered again through with the help of Lakshmikant. So again, take a look at do's and don'ts. Do not go for multiple sources, stick to the same resource. We are trying to keep it usually as minimum as possible. Try to go for multiple readings. Stop wasting time. Stop paying attention to the rumors and follow a disciplined approach in order to maximize your chances for success. Thanks a lot for watching. Please do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll be back again with pretty good stuff. Thank you very much.